I never had the specific plan to be here. With the moment I came here, I realized, okay, you did something right in your life. Yeah, you did something right with your career till now, and you're definitely gonna go for this. And I mean, like, seeing all the possibilities around myself, seeing at the time I've been here, there's not a single day I don't wanna put everything I am into this place and to show everything I am at this place. Wrestling is a lot more than just part of a sport. It's just like a hybrid between a great performance, a dramatic thing you present to the audience. It gave me like something I could truly show something to the world, if you know what I mean.
Like, you watch Walter and Ilya and think, I mean, first of all, who owes the other one money during the course of that match? But that is one of the most, and they're guys I've known both of them for a long time, and I've seen both of them wrestle each other several times. That is one of the most physical things I've ever seen. And again, watching that match, and again, seeing out my little screen here, seeing Shawn Michaels react like this to everything that happened in that match. But that match is physical. If you look at it, I think they only touch the ropes maybe once in the whole match. Everything about it is physical, and telling that story about endurance and physicality. And that's why it sticks out. You know, if Walter chops someone in front of 10,000 people, everyone still goes, ooh, because those chops feel terrifying. But with no crowd, and the camera's a little bit closer, and the camera mic's turned up, that feels, just really does something to you.
For me personally, it's not a big thing to not having like an audience around me, because as soon as I step into this ring, it's a fight for me. I fight. I'm focused on my opponent. Everything I do is just to drive forward and just to have a real battleground in this ring. So I'm focused on other things than this. And I'm too confident to be like, to get myself like a barrier between myself because of this situation. Like pushing myself to the limits. Everybody who watches me in the ring knows that nothing is more important for me. And this is exactly what I get here. Just get pushed to the limits, and I'm far from over right now. There's still a lot to come.
I couldn't believe it when I got invited to be here. I was in Germany and I was watching a movie, unlocked my phone, there was the email, and locked my phone again. Did I imagine that? Unlocked the phone. Nope, it was the real deal. It was my brother when I have a younger brother, and he used to watch it after school. Like, I remember the storyline where Edge was marrying Vicky Guerrero, and I was like, this is insane, and what is this, like, this mad thing you're watching? And then as the years kind of grew on, I used to always watch it, and just kind of in the back of my mind, I'd be really, really paying attention to it. And then he stopped putting it on. He kind of actually grew away from wrestling, and I grew more and more invested. And then it would be like, oh, are you not watching the thing? You don't want to find out what happened with Randy Orton and Christian? And I ended up putting it on. I ended up paying for the pay-per-views. I ended up getting more and more invested than I ever expected to get. So yeah, from then, I don't know when it hit me. I think it was honestly when I went to my very first training session. I feel like I decided then and there, like I decided on this, that very day, that I was gonna pursue this no matter what, after my first training session.
Yeah!
I wouldn't be here if I wasn't trying to get to the top. So I do want to do everything I possibly can here. And as long as I meet my own expectations, then, and they're pretty high, I expect a lot from myself. So I'm just going to take it every day. And if I'm not happy with myself, then I'll change something and I'll work harder.
We're doing a photo shoot which is inspired by Vanity Fair, and it's most certainly up my street. Designer gowns, shoes, makeup, hair, everything that you want, it's here. It's been a very fun day, very fun day.
The NXT UK is the best that we've got here across all of Europe now. And, you know, we're just showing, we're now a worldwide brand, and we're showing the whole world our culture here in London, in England.
We're dressing up, we're feeling good about ourselves, we're in a location, we're doing a shoot, we're having a good time, feeling good.
Yeah, we just had a couple of dry martinis, shaken, stirred.
Nice frill you've got.
Thank you, that's, I like to call that the license to frill.
Wow, shoot to frill, if you will.
I will.
Don't let anybody else tell you there was James Bond. I was the only James Bond and will remain James Bond.
He's managed to cultivate himself.
What did you call this boy?
I didn't want to do it without you.
Well, it looks like you did.
This wasn't my choice.
It was your choice.
No, it wasn't. No, it wasn't.
It was a choice. Because you could have not done it.
No. I didn't mean it.
You're testing me today, boy. You're really testing me.
Take me back.
Enjoy your interview, boy. Enjoy your interview, don't you
know? It's a one-time thing.
One time. Yeah, one time now.
No, you always do this. You always twist it. You always twist it.
Tell me how, boy. Go on. You've lost me.
I've been like taking pictures and promoting the brand. We're here in this unbelievable place. James Bond has been filmed here. I feel like James Bond girl. Since I announced my signature with WWE, like everything went crazy. People are just fascinating by my signature in France. I'm the first ever French female signed by WWE, so I think they need a French person to represent them, and I'm very happy to be that person. I know there's a lot to do. I hope I'll make them proud.
Because I had an acting first, so I always was like, oh, I want to do films like this, and I want to do like theatre like this. So I always wanted to play like the damsel in distress, the Bond girl, the like lonely widow roaming a castle. So like it was always the dream, but I didn't think wrestling would be the way into that, but here you go.
But here you are.
Anything exactly. Happens, man. Who knows?
Okay, we good?
Game today, mate.
Yeah, good game.
Good
sure.
Game today.
Not sure.
Good
now,
game today.
The disappointed walk off after a loss.
You were rubbish.
Hey,
you joking? You should see my free kick.
Yeah, so we were lucky enough to get to visit the Tottenham Hotspur Stadium today. I'm not the biggest football fan, but Trent and Ashton had a great day, you know, playing manager out on the football pitch. But I'm always interested in stuff like this, you know. Especially being able to experience different stadiums over in the States, being able to do the Royal Rumble and stuff like that, and comparing it to what we have in England. You know, who knows, maybe we'll get a SummerSlam or a WrestleMania one day. That'd be great.
That's been the instructions. That means give more, you've got the ball.
Win the ball. Let's have a white head on this.
Having that kind of experience, obviously, and being a football fan, like, as a kid, like, you know, it's just never not going to be cool, is it? Do you know what I mean? Like, as much as we've had, you know, been spoiled in our careers with these incredible stadiums that we've been able to perform at, still coming out on like a Premier League football ground is it's a very cool experience.
Like a venue, you can't knock a football stadium. Yeah.
There you can see the giant golden cock of Tottenham Hotspur fame. It's actually a 3D replica of the original Cockspur that was on the top of White Hart Lane. I know that just because I know a lot about football.
Have a look down. This is the part of the stadium.
Yeah, my legs are going a little bit
where a lot of the noise is generated from.
Actually,
it's alright. It's okay. Hey, I was thinking about it before, and we were actually discussing whether I'd actually do it for without any harness, and the answer is no.
This is easy.
It's actually worse. At first,
when I'm there, we're getting one shot, and we're all going back down. Okay.
Oh, God. And then that bit when you go on the
You have to look. Oh! Does that not make you feel like falling?
No, it's the worst.
Does it? Does it not make you feel like it's sucking you in?
Trying to deal with my face. Walking up the cheese grater pathway, mildly confident that I could probably get round there on a dry day with no harness, but when there's an edge. That's what I don't like. If there's a rail there, I don't care how high it is. But when there's just the edge, it's frightening. Frightening. But yeah, it's a very good experience. Wonderful. I recommend it.
It's actually not bad once you walk up.
That's fun. It does mess with your head.
I was all right with the walk. I'm not too bad with heights. I think it helped how scared Trent and Ashton were. That made me feel a bit more confident. But yeah, it was fun. It's a good experience.
Horrible. It was horrible. I'm not going to lie. It was horrible. But a great experience at the same time. I'm just glad I never have to do it again. And I could say that I did do it.